The natural world has done a good job of producing things of pretty much every color you can imagine. And some things are showy with their color, flashing them all in a rainbow of iridescence depending on how you look at them. There are iridescent butterflies and beetles, iridescent peacocks and pigeons. Oil and soap on water create iridescent colors too. There are even some iridescent gemstones like opals and pearls. But sometimes iridescence can be found in unexpected places, like on the surface of everyday iron ore, known as hematite. And while iridescent hematite is a beautiful and unusual addition to collector shelves, it's a bit of a mineralogical puzzle, because scientists aren't sure exactly why it's so pretty. Hematite is an iron oxide mineral, which is one of the main components of iron ore. With 2 parts iron to 3 parts oxygen, it actually has the same chemical formula as rust, but in its mineral form, it's like rust has had the ultimate makeover. Hematite can occur as silvery crystals, red rounded masses looking like petrified bubbles, or as glittery, finely crystalline chunks. But if hematite is like rust with a makeup artist, then iridescent hematite, which flashes its rainbow colors all over its surface, looks more like a toddler left unattended with the makeup bag. The story of this rainbow colored rock begins relatively recently. In the 1990s, an American mineral dealer by the name of Rock Courier, yes, really, heard about an especially colorful rock coming out of an iron mine in southeastern Brazil. Apparently, every year for a festival in the local village, the miners would load up a dump truck with this rainbow-colored rock and dump it out all over the road where they'd sparkle and shine like peacock feathers. So when Rock Courier got there, true to his name, he loaded about 15 tons of this color rock into barrels and shipped them back to the US. This came as a surprise to the locals, who were much more used to dealing in serious iron ore and only thought of their peacock-colored hematite as a curiosity. Despite his optimism, Rock Courier didn't have much luck selling his color rock, even though he was offering a bargain price of about $6 per kilogram. But once he realized that individual pieces were valued as collector's items and were even being used for jewelry, he fished the best bits out of his barrels and made his fortune. Since then, Courier's color rock and other specimens of iridescent hematite from around the world have become prized collectibles. The samples are sometimes also known as tergite, after the Turginsk mine in Russia where iridescent hematite was first found. But official mineral names are only ever given to distinct minerals, and that's where tergite runs into trouble. Although we know this is hematite, and we can see that it's an especially colorful variety of hematite, it seems that no one is really sure what exactly sets this variety apart, or how its iridescence works. The first attack to tackle the problem were a pair of researchers from Caltech in 2003. They used high-resolution microscopes and light absorption techniques to look at the physical and chemical properties of the iridescent hematite from Brazil. These analyses seemed to show that the iridescence occurred as a result of a separate thin layer on top of the hematite crystals. The layer had a higher concentration of aluminum and phosphorus, and the researchers suspected it was a different mineral than the hematite underneath. But the layer was too fine to be able to say anymore. But even without knowing what it was made of, the structural information suggested that the colors were caused by something called thin film iridescence. This is a similar mechanism to how oil spilled over water or soap bubbles produce their rainbow sheen. It happens when a thin layer has a different refractive index to the underlying material. Light rays pass through the film and are bent or refracted by different amounts. So when the light comes back out, the waves are slightly out of phase and interfere with each other, favoring some wavelengths and colors over others, producing a rainbow effect. Even though the chemistry of the layer itself hadn't been identified, no progress was made for years until in 2018, researchers from Penn State University published a paper which picked up the iridescent hematite again. These researchers noted something that didn't fit with the previous thin film explanation. They reported that whenever they broke a new piece off a chunk of the Brazilian hematite, there was more iridescence inside. The colors seemed to penetrate much further than just a thin coating. So this time, they threw the whole toolbox at the Brazilian color rock, using more advanced instruments than were available the first time around. A variety of different tools and techniques looked at the mineral surface features and chemical composition, mapped the surface topography on a fine scale, and measured the crystal structure. And the analyses seemed to confirm their color all the way down theory. Instead of a layer on top, the high-res scans showed that the hematite itself was made up of tiny nanocrystals shaped like cigars. The crystals were made of iron oxide, but with aluminum and phosphorus mixed in instead of iron every 10 atoms or so. They are stacked on top of each other at 120 degree angles, creating a threefold symmetry of star-like shapes, and each crystal was just a few hundred nanometers long and about 50 nanometers wide. Now, those sizes are important because they're within the same range as the wavelength of visible light, and the researchers think it's this that's causing the iridescence. Essentially, the nanocrystal lattice creates what's called a diffraction grating. That's where light bouncing off a structure with regular ridges and grooves interferes with itself, amplifying some wavelengths and colors and canceling out others. This so-called structural color creates the multicolored reflections from CDs and DVDs, but also the colors of some butterfly wings and the rainbow coloring to thin wispy clouds. In the geological world, it causes the colors of opals and shiny blue labradorite. And according to the Penn State researchers, the iridescent hematite too. But that's not the end of this story. In early 2025, the original Caltech scientists published a new study that doubled down on their thin film interference theory. This time, they didn't just look at the Brazilian color rock, but studied examples of iridescent hematite from Mexico, the US, the UK, and Italy, using similar high-res techniques to their Penn State colleagues. And their analysis showed that in all cases they could find, the rocks had a thin coating of the cigar-shaped nanocrystals. They even showed places where the star-shaped lattice stopped, revealing smooth hematite material underneath. Among all of the specimens they looked at, they couldn't replicate the findings of nanocrystals all the way down. So, which is the right? Thin film or diffraction grating? Oil slick or DVD? Maybe one or the other sets of researchers missed something or assumed too much. Or it could be both, with different mechanisms genuinely operating for different samples, or even within samples. The techniques used to measure nanoscale crystals are pinpoint accurate, but they can only ever look at a tiny area of a single sample. What's more, it's getting more and more difficult to study the Brazilian color rock because our rock couriers, 15 tons have all been sold. And we can't just go and grab more because the seam of iridescent hematite is sitting under a road that leads to the rest of the very important and lucrative iron mine. So digging it up for the sake of a few sparkly specimens isn't really an option. But there are still places where researchers and enthusiasts can get their hands on some colorful hematite, including several locations in the US. One of those places is Graves Mountain in Georgia, and SciShow Rocks Walk subscribers are in luck because that is the source of this month's collector's piece. Subscribers will receive their very own piece of iridescent hematite, just like this one, and whatever actually causes it to be shiny, it will be very shiny. Subscribers receive an ethically sourced mineral every month in this beautifully designed box right to their door, along with a handy info card telling you all the fun facts about your new specimen. If you want to sign up for the waitlist, head over to scishow.rocks or click the link in the description, where you can also peruse our other a la carte offerings of all kinds of rocks.